Featherweight, Kehl! Chingiz!
Outside leg kick early on from Enriko Kehl. Southpaw stance for Kehl in the black trunks. Into the inside leg. Trying to force Allazov back early.
Hey, don't grab.
Yeah, this is Kehl's style. He likes to keep that pressure on, likes to close that distance, try to get his opponent's back up against that wall. You can see Allazov immediately starts firing off that right hand.
Very high, tight guard on Enriko Kehl. Good inside leg kick there from Kehl. Allazov's got to be careful not to get too wide in his stance. The wider he is, the less his mobility will be, and Kehl will go after the legs. Also, when it gets close, look for Enriko Kehl to use the turning heel kicks. Another reason they call him the Hurricane. Good boxing combination here from Kehl. The aggressor meter early from Enriko Kehl.
You can see Kehl is not allowing that warm-up period. Allazov starting a little bit slower, but Kehl immediately started this match in third gear, and he's pushing that pressure on him.
You know, I think part of the reason why he's doing that, Mitch, is because, like you said, the last match was a nail-biter, and they had five rounds. They only have three to get it done here.
That uppercut off the left hand was the best punch of the opening round so far. There's another one from Allazov. Starting to find his rhythm a little more now, Chingiz Allazov.
Allazov's got superior accuracy. Every kick, he takes his time. You know, he might not throw a lot of shots, but the shots that he does throw are extremely accurate and find their mark.
With Kehl's guard being this high, the liver is exposed, and so far we've seen Allazov go a few times to that right section of the body, the liver section on Kehl, which is already starting to redden. Maybe a chink in the armor of Enriko Kehl. There it is again, a twisting left hand to the body, just trying to impact the vagus nerves and close down the liver.
That left kick is just beautiful. There's no setup, it comes up so fluid, and it just keeps touching him on the right side of his head.
Inside leg from Kehl, a high kick from Allazov. Allazov circles away from the power side of the southpaw. Knee on the inside. No grappling in this one of his kickboxing rules. Counters off the leg kick, does Kehl, full extension on the left hand.
You see Kehl's right shoulder starting to get reddened up because that left kick is starting to touch him actually on the shoulder. He's going to the head and the shoulder and sometimes the body with that left kick from Allazov.
As the round has gone on, Allazov has found the opening a lot more with his hands. Good forearms guard against the high kick there from Kehl. Nice counter left down the tube. Short left hook from Kehl. And just a dump there from Chingiz Allazov will receive a warning. Again, that's a Muay Thai technique not permitted in kickboxing. Into the first roars. In one super series, there are no extension rounds. Aggressive start again from Kehl. Allazov starting a lot quicker than he did the first round. Wants to go toe-to-toe with Enriko Kehl.
I like it when Kehl throws four fives. You know, he throws multiple punches when he gets in nice and tight. As you can see, Kehl's throwing those multiple shot combinations. He throws four punches, he throws five punches, and then he throws those low kicks. That's where he has success. He needs to keep those shots coming.
Kehl also needs to be careful when he extends on that straight left cross. Not to tip his head too far forward because the left side of his head becomes exposed and there could be a counter, especially a right roundhouse kick from Allazov. Allazov again working to that liver.
I think it was an adjustment in the corner that Enriko Kehl was making because you could see that Allazov threw that left high kick again and Enriko Kehl leaned back this time and avoided. So I think it's after the combination is thrown, Allazov is trying to throw that left leg kick or that left kick at the head of the body just as a counter shot. And Enrico's starting to catch it. See, he's starting to counter that kick now.
Referee Olivia Costa, a former Muay Thai fighter himself. Roundhouse kick, nice one to the midsection there from Allazov. Overhand right. The one Super Series debutante in the green and gold. Good stiff uppercut off the right hand there from Allazov. Gets on the outside of the jab as Cal walks forward. Through knee to the upper right ribs. 1 minute five remaining. Second round of three. Unofficially, we had the first round, a drawn round.
This is a good round for Enriko Kehl. Lots of pushing forward. And he's also showcasing some head movement. You can see that Allazov is starting to throw left, like he's starting to throw one shots. Enriko Kehl is starting to slip off that. But this is his style of match. He likes to keep that distance tight and let those hands go. Beautiful light hand.
Jumping knee from Enriko Kehl, good airborne. Comes over the inside.
Yeah, I think Enriko is finally finding his rhythm in this round, and he's done a great job. Earlier in the round, you can see when Allazov landed the kicks, like the moment the kick landed, Enriko was still moving forward, ready to just counter, just like he did right there off of that kick, but he caught it.
Very good round for Enriko Kehl. And just takes a blow to the 6 o'clock.
Sure. See, this is what we saw when Enriko Kehl fought Liam Nolan. Just that constant pressure. And he was able to find success, especially in rounds two and three, by just overwhelming his opponents. He needs to keep this pressure on Allazov.
To Enriko Kehl after two with one round remaining. Kehl immediately on the front foot, backing up Allazov. Here's for a chance to enter the top five in the most stacked division in the world. In one super series featherweights where number one ranked is Giorgio Petrosian.
I like it when Allazov switches to southpaw and starts throwing that kick. You saw him take out the leg early. But then when he goes back to orthodox, that's when Enriko Kehl kind of finds his moments, especially with the punches. He's able to close that distance and let go of those hands.
Nice little turn, pivot there from Allazov in simple stance now.
Allazov has found that head movement. He's slipping off the center line and evading and countering.
A little bit more snap about Chingiz Allazov. Good front kick to the midsection, eats an uppercut. Switching stance to orthodox now. Kehl has remained in southpaw the entire contest. Good counter off the leg kick there from Kehl.
This is the Chingiz Allazov that I've been watching for the past couple years. His evasion, his timing, his movement, but then that ability to come right back after his opponent missed. Make you miss, and then make you pay. There's Kehl.
Right hand on the inside to the orbital there of Allazov. And look at Kehl trying to cut off the movement. Keep Allazov on the outside. It's a very big circle they're working in. And Mitch, I'm not sure that Allazov has ever fought outside of an actual ring.
Yeah, he's not used to this rule. Said he's not used to this circumference of the circle that he's got to work with. You know, he's used to backing up in the corners and then circling off of the corner. This time, it's the corners never ending. It's just constantly there.
And Rich Franklin, it is a very big circle. There's a lot more room here for kickboxers, strikers than in a regular boxing ring.
Yeah, there is. And there are no corners that you can get trapped in either. You can't use the ropes to bounce off of or anything like that. So any of the work that Allazov would normally do against the ropes, he doesn't have the ability to do that.
It has been an adjustment for Chingiz Allazov. And again, is this going to be a round of almost two halves? Allazov came out strongly at the start of the round after Kehl initially backed him up. Now we see Kehl powering forward again. Good left hand.
And it's like these guys split the round in half. You see the first part goes to one, and then the second part goes to the other. Look at Kehl turning it on right now. He wants this victory back. He wants to redeem himself.
Very good scoring punches from Enriko Kehl.
Yeah, you've seen a couple heavy, heavy crosses land from Enriko Kehl here, and I think that he's actually getting better on the inside towards the end of this round when you're looking at the combinations.
Man, I wish this was a five-rounder. We need more answers. Come on, you're right? Not enough time.
No, exactly.
Enriko!